Facebook dropped something new onto us React developers because they released the React Strict DOM package. And before you worry, no worries, it's not something you have to learn right now, it's not stable yet, and it might not matter to you at all. It's also not part of React 19, which was also announced, and I do analyze that in a separate video, to which you find a link below the video here. But React Strict DOM, nonetheless, is an interesting project, which currently is in experimental status, so you can't really use it yet, or you shouldn't really use it yet. But what's the idea behind this React Strict DOM package? Well, the main idea is to simplify the process of building cross-platform applications. Now you might wonder, don't we have React Native for that already? And yes, we do. But this package, React Strict DOM, is essentially meant to help React Native or React developers who don't just want to target either native apps, native platforms, iOS and Android, as you currently do with React Native, or the web. But what if you instead want to build for both main platforms? So if you want to build a mobile app for iOS and Android, and at the same time, based on the same code base, a web application, what if you want to do that? That's not as easy to do right now, and this package aims to simplify it because the main idea behind this package is essentially to give you a DOM emulation, you could say, that's based on the browser DOM and how that works, so that you can use a set of elements that also are in the end based on the elements you can use in web apps, that will then translate to their fitting equivalents depending on whether you're building for a mobile platform or the web. And that essentially means that with that package, once it is stable, you could bring it into your React project and you would use those elements by this package in your JSX code. And then depending on which platform you're building for, this would be translated to the fitting elements for the target platform. And you can also see that in the source code of this package here, because in there you find code where you can see how different elements are translated to different target elements based on which kind of platform you are building for. And it's not just about elements, it's also about giving you uniform access to some web and browser APIs, even if you're not targeting the web, so that the most common and popular features you might know from the web, from the browser, can then also be used if you're building native apps. And that is why I think that this is a rather interesting initiative and project, but it's of course also a project that, besides being in experimental status right now, won't matter to everyone. If you're using React to build web apps, you very likely won't need that. If you're only using React Native to build mobile apps and you're not interested in using the same code to build a web app, you also won't need this. And even if you are targeting all different platforms, you still might not want to use that because you might want to tweak your code depending on the target platforms you're building for. And it might not just be tiny tweaks, but big enough changes that you want to have separate projects. That's all viable, and therefore this is not a project you have to learn right now. You can't really use it yet anyways. It's changing a lot. It's in experimental status, as I mentioned. But nonetheless, it's a project to keep an eye on, I'd say, if you are interested in targeting multiple platforms. But it's also a project not everyone will need, and it's also not a project that would be related to React 19 or a big change that's coming to React. Nothing of that, just an additional package that can help some developers once it is stable, at least potentially.